apron, this chimney breast. And it's got notoriously out of plumb bull noses. Well, you'll never get one. Well, really, you'll get one that's true. You'll always have to do some splicing on these things. Well, this first length I put on, as you put the first piece on, first side on, you have to do some relief cuts on the corner of your bull nose here. And obviously run it round. But then when you come to this side, on this one, chimney breast feeds into one stack. So you've got this funny angle. And your paper will run out. So as it hits the corner there, see it's starting to ride up. So no alternative. I've had to put some relief cuts so it will sit tight on this bend. And just the odd relief cut up this side and just trim it. So then every other length now, I will put on to the same distance and then run a full piece round this arch piece, splicing it along here. Again, this being emulsioned, so I probably will, well, no, I will have to do some filling afterwards. I'll show you what I'm going to do. So when your first length's on, what you'll start to notice is that every one that you start to put on after this will get more difficult because it's starting to run out. So you only get it to sit on so much, and already it's sitting funny on these edges. So as long as you've got it lined up and your joints are flat, just get it on and leave it, because it'll shrink back. Any bubbles you can slice. Any bubbles you can slice and just address them as you're going along. Essential that you keep all these cuts nice and straight.
This is going to be emulsion, so make sure there's no paste on it.
What we need to do, obviously, keep all these cuts in line, so then when your next pieces come on, they all sit nice and you're not getting any great big edges sitting out. Notice how it's not quite wanting to sit right, but they will start to come out when I start to finish. That's the joint that would have run out on this curve. So again, I'll put a full piece in and just splice it in. When you come to make these relief cuts on these bull noses, I'll show you on this one because it's easier than showing on the top one. Literally the curve is just starting here. So just make a mark on the curve. Bring a bit of a line out. Generally, you're knowing that's where the paper's going to sit, but also these run out, so don't make any cuts that way. So just make one cut to the point. You need to have sharp scissors for this one, especially on the tips. And then just snip to the line. Only just a little bit there. And then that way, you start to. So it starts to go around the corner, but again, you have to put a few more relief cuts in. We just get it perfect. It's already starting to go round. Just one more. And again, these won't be true. So it'll start to sit awkward, but that's round that corner out. The trick about keeping neat lines when you come to cutting is when you get the scissors in, don't follow where you're cutting. Obviously, you need to know that it's sitting on the line, but you're looking at the tip of your scissors, following the tip of your scissors. Obviously line up where you're cutting, but then always keep the tip of your scissors in your eye, in your line of sight. So that's the last piece on the chimney breast. Put a couple of relief cuts just on this side here for the arch. The opposite relief cuts here. I've just spliced it in so that'll fill after it's been emulsioned. Really, the only bad part about this chimney breast was, I mean, it was running out a little bit. As long as you keep your joints right on the face of it, then when you come to these release around the corners, then see how this one's running out. But that one will fill. It's not a problem for me. And always remember, finish one wall before you start the other. So you just don't get any steps as you're coming down with your joints. Also, to ensure that these corners sit nice and tight, I just run polyfiller down the corner, and then when it dries, knock off any edges with your scraper and then just wipe it over with a damp cloth, and then that way you get nice and neater corners. It'll ensure the paper will stick. And the main reason why we line the walls being that there's so many different textures on these old walls. And if you were to mulching over that, you would see, especially on broad walls, you'd see all the imperfections in the wall. So by putting the lining paper on, it gives it an even texture. And when it shrinks back onto the wall, what it will do is where there's any deviations, where there's been any filling done, I mean, this is quite ripply, this one. They will show, like this one here. You can just see that under the paper there. So it would form a shadow when the light strikes it. So again, when you've emulsioned, what you can do is knock them out and fill it across the bottom there. Knock them out, knock the shadows out by just putting some filler over. I've just got these bull noses on this window wall to look at. Again, the reason why I would finish one wall before starting another is because on this wall I'm going to do it slightly different. I've already marked it out. I'm going to pop a length here to here, splitting the sill, so then I can just pop a full length, which will run right the way along. Just saves a lot of messing around, cutting around this area. And so on this top piece, I'm going to put the straight edge of the paper and offer it up. I'll put a mark so I know where I'm going. Just need to find it there. I put that straight edge in there, saves a lot of cutting. So I'll get this on first of all. See the shadows in the wall. I'll get rid of them. But it's not sitting right. These again are notoriously out. So what I will do, I'll split this.
Right, so that's the bullnose paper now. And not easy to do. This one's going to need a bit of touching up and a bit of filling. It'll twist. These will. We're filling up on that one. But I'll address it when I emulsion it. Right around the window. It's looking pretty good. Still wants another coat of stain yet. I'm still going to touch that up, but that's looking a lot better. These little bits on the bull noses, they can be filled and they'll be hidden. On this side, this is really, that's the worst one. But again, I can sort that out. That ain't going to be a problem. Another one, another joint. Just here. A little bit there. Again, all these will go. The bull noses, you can't do anything with them. So that's looking really good there now. And the radiator sorted. Again, this one's one more coat of stain, and then undercoat some gloss the woodwork. I'm done.